Hello and a warm welcome to Art House. I'm Melinda Akinlami. On the program today, a veteran artist will be taking us on a journey through time with his sculptural pieces. Then we visit the National Gallery of Art to find out what's up their sleeves. And we still have your works of art for this week. So sit back, relax, and let's take this ride together. Details will be coming your way in a moment.
In England, writers write to entertain. But for a Nigerian writer in my position, you can't go into that. Every generation must recognize and embrace a task it is peculiarly designed by history and by providence to perform.
Journey Through Time is the title of this exhibition, which took place at the Resource Place in Lagos. And it's interesting because one veteran is celebrating another.
Chiseled Wonders is what veteran artist Roland Ogyame is presenting in this exhibition, which he calls Journey Through Time. But he is not alone. Veteran Adebanjo Fashui, who is featuring as a guest artist, is also bringing his latest collection of sculptural pieces in calabash and plastic design to be displayed at the Resource Place in Lagos.
We have two very prolific artists. This time around, we are hosting artists whose main medium is sculpture. We have Pa Roland Ogyame, a very prolific artist who has been in the industry for so long. As a matter of fact, about 60 years. I've known him for the better part of 40 years, you know, because he used to have a studio at Unity Road, Ikeja. And I started following his work when I was much younger, maybe in my teens. He used to come around to see my father, who was also then, you know, in the art scene. And hosting him this time around in the family gallery is a no-brainer, because of the prolificness of his art. If you look around, these are works that he has collected over 20, 30 years, and they still represent contemporary ideas.
Ogyame is one of the leading sculptors in Nigeria today. But we have been together for more than 40 years when he was in Lagos. And I bought one or two of his works personally. I see in my studio down there. When he was coming to do the exhibition, I was really happy that the exhibition is going to hold here so that I can join him. So the idea is, he's exhibiting sculpture, I'm exhibiting sculpture. Why can't we together? There must be fellowship. And he give us room for you to see my type of work and the type of work. And you can compare. I'm using plastic, I'm using gold, this is wood.
This 74-year-old has gone through several stages in his artistic career, from the early 60s when he honed his skills under master sculptor Erabo Emokpae on Igun Street, which has become home to many bronze works, to when he started birthing his own ideas in the 70s. And now, he's passing that knowledge to the younger generation, especially at the Agbarato Harmattan workshop in Delta State.
I've always told them that art is a good profession. I always tell them that art is like an elephant. If you as a hunter cut down and kill an elephant, you don't share it. Everybody goes there to go and take whatever he likes. So there's more than enough for people in an elephant. So the field of art, wood carving, is like an elephant that is never exhausted. There's always be a market for it. Even though you want to sell it urgently, it's not possible, because carving are not sold like bread. What inspired me is the spirit of art that gave me an idea of what to produce. When I was young, there are some of the work here I can finish for a week or even 3 days. But at my age now, for 6 months, I may not be able to finish one work. There are some of the work that I've been producing for more than 3-4 years before I can totally finish it. So it takes a long time to produce one of these works.
Roland Ogyame is one great artist I've been following in the last 10 years. And so I can confidently say that he's someone who has done very, very well in the art. He's a great sculptor. And this exhibition titled Journey Through Time is to reflect on all that he has been doing over the years. He's somebody who has done very well and one should commend him.
Mr. Ogyaman works with treated wood. Some have been treated for 15 years so that termites can't touch them, while others have a natural repellent, an assurance that these sculptural pieces will stand the test of time.
I prefer sculpting because I enjoy doing that hard job, because it is unique. It is not for every people and it's not for lazy people. The table is a documentation of the coronation of an Oba in Benin Kingdom. That is the top. If you look at the four legs on which it stands, it represents a happy home. You see the women and each of the four legs is a husband and wife, even with children, in a happy mood. So it's two combinations, the tradition, coronation of an Oba in Benin, and the happy home as a base. And this work was done in 1981 or 82, that is after the coronation of Oba Erediawa. That was when I decided to do this work. Is the impression, the observation that I had during the coronation that inspired me to do it.
While Mr. Fasuyi is showing off about 10 pieces of his newfound love, where he uses plastic to create intrinsic designs, plus the beauty of the calabash is not left out as well.
My works are unique, and that is my creation. What I've done is to bring into use some local materials. That's what we call the god Kilegbe. Most people know it for storing palm oil, but you can use it for other things. And this is what I've done. I've cut it to shape, to a new form in sculpture. So it's unique. It's nowhere in the world. But they are doing it. I've not opened it to the public yet. What I've seen do some experiments on it. But I must say that in 1984, when I exhibited them in Paris, I sold 18 out of my 20 works. So it has been accepted in principle as a good work, unique, for its own. It's not like anybody's work. It's based on the materials I'm using and the limitation of the shape. When you have wood, you can do those spell, but when you have plastic, can like going up or clay, you are limited by what you can do with it. So that's the unique of it. And of course, it's going to give room for more artists to explore local materials to do art.
Fasuyi has always been a painter, but not many people know the other side of him as a sculptor. So what he's doing here is exhibiting with Paul Ogyame, and he's showcasing his pieces. His medium, mainly the god, what we call Kerigbe in Yoruba land. He uses a lot of plastic, he uses a lot of fiberglass, and he comes out with works that are quite contemporary. I think the combination of the two of them gives us gives the next generation of artists some inspiration, because they will draw a lot of ideas from what these two gentlemen of the arts are doing.
He hasn't been exhibiting, but he has great works that we have actually encouraged him to exhibit. This is his 84th birthday, and there was need for him to showcase to the world what he is able to do. You see in his works what he has transformed calabashes into. They are great items. He has also used plastics, and these are things that you will ordinarily not look at and think of. But he's used them, and used them very well. His works are quite exceptional. He's someone that many young artists should come and look at and begin to draw inspirations from.
Sculpture is a traditional Nigerian art. Painting is not. We acquired painting about 50 years ago through training. We were the first set of people to train as painters in this country. And in fact, I was the first one to graduate in painting. So painting is an imported art, where sculpture is our local one. And it has influenced the development of modern art. Because when Picasso, the United States, picked one or two African motifs and sculpture, and introduced his painting, that was the beginning of modern art. Then you see the combination of Western European style with form coming from Africa. And then, of course, the print, the colors, Japanese, making what we call modern art. So for people to appreciate what we are doing, they have to realize that this is their own legacy. They should uphold it.
These men have shown that age is no barrier to creativity, as they keep pushing the boundaries, even as they reflect on how time has gone by in their journey through the arts.
I like the concept. Those great men are still making impact in the art world, and I don't know where they get the strength from, to be quite honest. I know Mr. Fasu is always saying that this is the best time to create works of art because he isn't disturbed by the worries of life. He just takes it one day at a time, and that's food for thought. It reminds me of the works of art you send in every week. Take a look.
These are the images you sent in this week. The Power of Imagination is a work of art done with acrylic on canvas by Ezekiel Danok. While Ahmad Sariyaku has The Merrymaker done with oil on canvas. Ejiofo Orochukwu has Your Energy, it's done with mixed media. While this charcoal on paperwork is Raji Folorunsho's work, he calls Smile. Caution is an acrylic on canvas piece done by Godswill Chima. While Folk Muse is a pastel on chipboard work done by Femi Ayobami. Okeowo Bosede Debbie has this work of art. She did it with acrylic paint on cardboard. It's called Hold On. And those are the works of art you sent in this week. We encourage you always to keep them coming, put your best foot forward, and the right information beside that work of art.